Hi everyone, hopefully you're all doing well. Welcome back to Skin Masterclass. I'm Chida Mielmaz, your personal skincare coach, teaching you effective ways to achieving your healthy skin through education and well-being. And I always say, there's always more to learn and more to share when it comes to skincare and educating you in the best possible skincare products for you to use and ingredients and routines and everything really. So I would love for you to stay, so please subscribe to my channel because I upload every single week and I'm trying to up my game actually. So I'm trying to apply 2 times a week. So the more you watch, the more motivated I get, and it will help a ton if you like, comment and also subscribe, because that really helps with the YouTube algorithm, which apparently is depending on your actions on the videos. So whoever you are watching, by the way, any influencer, any blogger, any kind of professional you are watching and you really appreciate their content, please show that appreciation. It just promotes the video and puts it in front of more people, so more people learn and more people share. So anyway, I'm going to be talking to you about sensitive skin and micro tearing. I see a lot of clients, and I've just seen a client actually that who just left, who had redness on her skin. And when I actually asked her the question, what, I'm not giving any brand names because I don't want to brand shame, that's not what I do. If you've noticed, I don't push any brands to you, nor do I say don't use this brand as well. I would rather make you come to that conclusion, because I remember every skin is different and every skin need is different as well. So one thing I don't want to do is tell you, oh my god, this product is so bad, stop using it, but it might really work for you, and vice versa. It might be something that really works for me but might not work for you. So I love to give you the education and the science behind it, so the theory as per se, and then that application, yes, I'm able to tell you what kind of application, what kind of sensory feeling you are getting. Is it, you know, gliding well, is it sticky? But in regards to making a difference on your skin, it really depends on your skin. And that's why I do my consultations privately, to analyze exactly what your skin type is, to analyze exactly what your skin needs is, and then give you a specific advice on the routine and products to purchase. So let's talk about micro tearing and sensitivity. So again, I decided, I just had a client, she had this permanent redness on her skin. I have asked her to tell me what products she's using, also how she's using it and the consistency of she's using it as well. And she was using a physical scrub every single day. In some cases, actually, she was using it day and night, because she said to me, Chida, I really like the feeling after you use a physical scrub, how you feel your skin is fresh and really clean. I said to her, and I'm also telling you, that it doesn't mean that the more you scrub your face, your skin will be cleaner. There's no such thing. You don't need to exfoliate your skin every single day, because that would create you sensitivity. This is why there is a specific brand out there that everyone is naming and shaming in terms of it being really bad for your skin. Well, I'll say it because it's like very commonly known, the Scent Ives scrub. This client, and specifically, she wasn't using the Scent Ives scrub, by the way, but she was using something with walnut inside it, which is exactly the similar property to the Scent Ives scrub. You don't want to use physical scrubs every day anyway, but when you are using a physical scrub, you have to make sure that the granules are circular, they're not misshaped, they're not misaligned, and they also, you have to go for exfoliators that disappear when you massage it in. You want it to get absorbed by the skin and get smaller and smaller and smaller as you're massaging it. Enzyme-based scrubs are great. They don't micro tear and sensitize your skin. I'll say you massage it for 20 to 30 seconds and you'll almost see that it turns creamy. There's no redness. So you don't want to be left with a red sore face after you exfoliate your skin, because that would essentially mean that it's a wrong type of exfoliant and your skin is getting sensitized towards it. I, for example, and I would advise everyone to use skincare products to get a benefit out of it. You don't want to use a product to get a damage out of it. And unfortunately, physical scrubs that contain big granules, that doesn't contain that even structure of a granule, and they don't disperse into the skin very easily, those are the granules that would micro tear and sensitize your skin, that it would weaken your skin barrier, it would damage your skin barrier, it would make your skin not able to retain moisture, because what you are doing is making the skin sensitive and hence increasing that moisture loss, that what we call transepidermal water loss from the skin, and making the skin much more damaged. When you damage the skin, it becomes more sensitive, and when the skin becomes more sensitive, the ceramide, the lipid, that function of the skin will weaken, and hence your hydration level that your keeps your skin hydrated and moist and healthy would deteriorate because you start losing that from epidermis. What we want to do is to protect the skin, repair skin barrier. What we want to do is strengthen the skin barrier. What we definitely do not want to do is to damage the skin barrier. And that's unfortunately what physical scrubs do. One, if you use the wrong physical scrub, but two, if you use the physical scrub, even if it's a good physical scrub, by the way, if you use it too often and every single day. Okay, my battery ran out, so I'm on my phone now. Do not go for walnut or sugar or coffee scrubs on the face. They're okay for the rest of the body because generally speaking, our body skin is much more resilient and it's not much sensitive. It's not as thin as our facial skin. So you can use like those kind of scrubs, but generally on the face, definitely avoid salt, sugar, coffee, and walnut scrubs. So that's a big no-no. And number two is, when you are physically exfoliating your skin, you have to make sure that you only exfoliate once, maximum two times a week. I personally would even say once a week, and that's really sufficient. Definitely don't want to do it every day, and you shouldn't do it day and night. You also want to avoid using physical scrub on acne skin. Your skin is already healing and it's already very sensitive. Skin barrier is already weakened. So what you don't want to do is like increase that sensitivity and increase that kind of redness and that irritation on the skin. So 100%, no matter what physical exfoliator it is, you don't want to scrub anything. When you have a wound, you don't want to scrub your acne. So that's a big, big no-no. If you're acne prone and you have that congestion, you can just do your T-zone, but just keep your acne area free of that physical scrub. Chemical scrub, which is BHA, AHA, yes, no problem. You can do that, but physical scrub, you have to avoid. If you have eczema prone skin and if you also have rosacea prone skin, I would generally avoid using physical scrubs for those kind of skin types as well. I would keep it very, very mild on the chemical exfoliants. Maybe you can use a low concentration of PHA, maybe lactic acid. Best type of skin that could tolerate with, I'll say, physical scrubs is congested oily skin types. Also mature. When your skin is mature, the skin renewal is slower. When you do physically exfoliate the skin, it would help. If your skin is congested, no acne though, congested, oily and mature, great. You can use it 1 to 2 times a week. But hopefully that was useful. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel, write every kind of questions you would like to be answered. I am very, very active in my comment section, both in Instagram and on YouTube, and I definitely would make a video addressing your skin concerns as well. If you would like to book a private skin consultation with me, I would love to be a part of your journey in finding you exactly the routine that works for your specific skin. I don't give any general advice, I give specific advice and design and create a skincare routine that is all about your skin and it's all about the products that would work for you. If you are interested in gaining more information and more education about acne and you want to know what type of acne you have, what type of hyperpigmentation you have, the treatment solution, the ingredients, and kind of a basic routine to follow when it comes to acne and hyperpigmentation management, I've created a 3-hour-long acne masterclass that you can watch and it will give you everything that you need to ever know about acne. So I'm going to link all of those down below. I'm going to go now and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys!